It may seem that making a horrible rip in a beautiful painting disappear is a bit like magic. There are four things about this process that you, as an easel painting connoisseur, need to know, and this video is going to give you the inside information. This painting fell off the wall when a small hanging nail gave way. One of those four points is the excellent craftsmanship required to rejoin the fibers of the rip.
If done properly, a small tear does not require a backing or a patch. However, a large tear like this will require that the painting is lined.
How often do you patch paintings?
Never. Here we've consolidated the fibers, and we're realigning the warp and the weft and connecting them with heat. It's a heat-activated adhesive.
Is it hard to fix a rip like this?
Well, it takes a lot of time to rejoin every fiber one by one and to make sure that everything it's realigned together.
You can see that the bringing together of this very frayed fabric is resulting in a flawless repair. Very nicely done. The second point I'd like to make is not the most visible, but it's the most important for long-term preservation, and that is treatments must be done to stop deterioration and stabilize the condition of the artwork. The point of impact and the ripping of the canvas and the paint stress the paint and causes severe cracking and cupping. If the paint layer structure is not stabilized, it will continue cracking for years and decades into the future. This stabilization is done with a lining. Another important part of stabilizing the painting is stabilizing the flaking which is occurring along the rips. We make every effort to save each flake in order to preserve the original integrity of the painting. It's a given that the in-painting or retouching should be of excellent quality, so that's not even on my list. It might surprise you that even if the colors match perfect on a retouching, that you still might be able to see the repair. The third important point that makes up quality work requires the matching of the textures of the repairs to the original. The fills where paint has been lost often needs to be textured to match the painting. During the in-painting or retouching process, often texture is added to make sure that it blends with the original. And finally, texturing with the varnish and making sure that the gloss matches the original is the final step in making sure that the repair is invisible to the naked eye. The fourth point is that the repair must be stable structurally and color-wise long-term. If the first three points that I've made are performed with quality materials, conservation grade, quality supplies, then there's a good chance that this repair will last far into the future and maximize the value of this painting financially, historically, and aesthetically. No attempt to deceive is made with these kinds of repairs, and in fact, all these repairs are visible with a UV blacklight.